Hi everyone, hope you're enjoying your vacation. Sorry to interrupt, but it's for a good cause. I wanted to share with you a little Dvar Torah. Don't like to send everyone away with a Dvar Torah, but not going over in class.
So let's go through it together.
Greetings, parents. Please allow me to share with you a Dvar Torah this week's Torah portion, Parshat Beshalach. Pesach, there are 2 days of Yom Tov, the first day of the seven and the last day of the seven. So in other words, if you look at the Yom Tov of Pesach,
it's interesting because there are 7 days that we have to refrain from eating chametz and 7 days we have to eat matzah.
Only the first day, the Torah says, is Yom Tov, and this and the last day is Yom Tov. The first 2 days in Arzot HaBrit, America, other places outside of Eretz Yisrael, are also, we keep 2 days of Yom Tov, but in Eretz Yisrael, we keep only 1 day of Yom Tov, but according to the Torah, the last day of the seven is also Yom Tov. The question is, why were these 2 days selected to be Yom Tov? Why not the first and the second? Why not the first and the middle? Why not the first? Why the first? Why not the last two? Why the first?
We know
and the last. That 7 days after the Jews left Mitzrayim, there was Kriyat Yamsuf. That's what's in the Kriyat HaTorah that we say on the seventh day of Pesach. But why is that relevant? Why is that enough of an event in and of itself that was my speak for the Torah to give us a Yom Tov on that day as well. So let's read on. What is special about these 2 days that we find a full Yom Tov on only these, explains Rabbi Yoshev, is that these 2 days are days of Yetziat Mitzrayim, leaving Egypt, but in very different ways. In Parshat Shemot, Hashem tells Moshe, Be'otiyacha ha'am mimitzrayim, when you take out the nation from Egypt. And in Parshat Va'era, it says, L'hotzi et b'nei Yisrael Yimitzrayim, to take the Jews out of Egypt. What is the difference between these two words?
These Rabbi two... Rabbi Yashiv explains.
And by the way, Rabbi Yashiv Zatzal, it wasn't long ago that he passed away. So he explains that just because you take the person out of Mitzrayim, Egypt, does not mean that you took the Mitzrayim, the Egypt, out of the person. Immigrants from foreign countries may have left their land, but they are soaked with the culture of the land they left behind. Those of us that have Russian ancestry, Russian grandparents or parents, we are in a way still Russians, Moroccans, Americans, and enter Israel. We would still be, even if we theoretically would leave and enter the land of Israel. Similarly, even after the Jews left the territory of Egypt, they didn't leave the mindset of Mitzrayim. They may have left Mitzrayim, could have entered Eretz Yisrael as full-fledged Mitzrayim. This explains the two psukim of leaving Egypt. On the 15th of Nisan, we left the territory of Mitzrayim, and for that we celebrate the first day of Pesach on the 15th. It was only at the Yam Suf, the Red Sea, that we shed our Mitzri habits and ways. We may have entered the Yam Suf as Mitzri, but we emerged on the other side as true B'nai Yisrael. That, says Rabbi Yoshev, was the Yetziat Mitzrayim in its own right, and of no less stature. For the Mitzrim leaving us, we celebrate the last day of Pesach as well as Yom Tov. The first day of Pesach commemorates that we actually left the borders of Egypt. But even when we leave the borders of Egypt, it's shed our habits, our Mitzri habits about ourselves. When we came into the Yam Suf and we emerged on the other side of the Yam Suf, we left behind completely, says Rabbi Yoshev, anything that was Mitzri about us. The last day of Yom Tov. That's what we're celebrating on the last day. And each one of those days, each one of those events is worthy enough to celebrate a Yom Tov. We must remember that while living here in America and enjoying the numerous wonderful habits that it gives us, we must never allow it to compromise on our set of values and principles. And maybe you all merit
to see the coming of the Messiah. Amen. Shabbat Shalom.